as you can see in this case, you know, there are different aspects. One is the intellectual aspect, where he feels that he is not able to concentrate when he is in conversation or when he is reading or when he is exerting, and he makes mistakes because his mind does not focus on that thing, it just wanders off here and there. So this is his first important concentration difficult during reading, conversation, mental exertion. This is the first aspect of his case. But the second aspect of the case is much more intense and characteristic, and that is that he says, I experience fear all the time, and the before I talk to anyone, even before I come here, I have to rehearse in my mind so many times so that I don't make mistakes or something like this. And this is the main story, as you can see, is the fear of new people or fear of undertaking something new or a new situation, a new school, a new job. And he is extremely conscious about what people have an impression of him, and therefore he does not express his own feelings or choices or opinions. He just agrees to whatever other people say, though he feels differently. He knows that it's, but in order to kind of not create a negative impression, he just goes along. And so after some time, he even forgot who he is or what he wants or who is a problem. He gets confused about his own identity because he's always trying to fit in with what people think about him. This is his biggest issue. Do you follow this? So in this way, you have to identify the person's problem or his state. Then it's easy, otherwise no. And then we have some concomitant symptoms, for example, the brittleness of the nails or the left-sided ear discharge, chronic otorrhea, or the hunger that comes soon after eating and the intolerance of hunger, or the yellow staining sweat, or the one more symptom was there, but I forgot. And the dream is there, of course. And then the clinging to the mother during the childhood. Cannot go out of the house. So this kind of are available. Here if you can identify all the symptoms, I put all of the intellectual symptoms here. Concentration difficult while calculating. Concentration difficult in conversation. Concentration difficult while talking. Concentration difficult while studying. Dullness from mental exertion. Forgetfulness for what he was about to do or what he has just read. Like this, I put all and then combined all of this into one rubric. I combined all of this into one rubric. Sorry. Yeah, you can see here. and this is the combined rubrics. All of these rubrics combined here. Because I thought if a remedy covers any of this, it is indicative of the, we don't have to take 10 rubrics for the same expression. Right? So you can actually get rid of this thing completely because all of them are here. And then the brittle nails is the physical concomitant. So when you look at that now, you can see the silica that is screaming there. The next remedy is lycopodium. But see the difference. Silica has 23 marks and 9 rubrics. Lyco 15 marks and 7, means far behind. And then you can see the brittle nails. Silica very strong. And also the otoria, isn't it? Left ear discharge, otoria. Silica is very well known for suppuration, chronic suppuration of one part. You can see here also that silica has the appetite soon after eating and aggravation from fasting. The clinging to the mother. The fear of undertaking anything new. This is a important symptom here, and silica is the main remedy for that. You can see here, fear, and under that, undertaking anything new. Here is a rubric, and you can see it's the main remedy for this. This is what he said, koi bhi naya, if I do something new, I get very, very anxious. So meeting new people, talking, all this kind of thing. And then he used to get convulsions from excitement if somebody reprimands him, scolds him, and strangers he couldn't take. And then there's a whole set of symptoms here, stage fright, cowardice, the ghost, the dark, the timidity in public, and the confusion about his identity. You can see it as three remedies, Medorinum of course, Silica and Argentum Nitricum. And gelsemium, all of those remedies for stage fright, isn't it? And lycopodium and carbovege. All these stage fright remedies are screaming there. But out of all these remedies, and then when you look at this set of symptoms here, so you then try to identify from a sensation point of view and a miasm point of view. The main sensation in his case is what? You can see the whole story is a pattern. The pattern is the pattern of appearance, isn't it? Would you agree? How do I look? How do I appear? What clothes I'm wearing? How do people see me? Right? Another is choice, isn't it? Identity. Who am I? What is my identity? What do I want as opposed to what others want for me? Another theme is familiarity. He wants everything familiar, no? He wants to be only in the house. He cannot go out. He don't want to meet new people, do new things. Isn't it? And he wants to hold on to his mother. Clinging, attached to his mother. So this is the pattern you can see. And this is a typical pattern of what? What does this indicate? Row 3, no? This is the row 3 pattern. Lycopodium does not have so much to do with his appearance or opinion or choice or identity. Neither does Argentum nor Medorinum. It is a third row quality. And what is the main theme in the miasm? You can see here, lot of anticipation, isn't it? And we see also a lot of avoidance. He won't do a lot of things because of the fear. And therefore he lives, he says, a very restricted life, isn't it? I'm just like this. This is very typical of psychotic miasm. And then in the row 3, where does he come? So on the left side, people say, I don't have a choice. Means I don't know what I want. and on the right side they say, I know what I want and I will do this only, like phosphorus, sulfur. They'll not do what you say, they'll do what they want. Silica lies in the middle, means he knows what he wants, but he is not able to do it because he is too concerned about what people think about him. This is where his problem is. So here you have a remedy that has the sensation, the miasm. What is the main keynote of silica? In mind, what is the main keynote? What? In mind symptom. What the main symptom of silica? Stage fright, no? What do we know silica for? Stage fright. Fear of exam, fear of stage, fear of failure, fear of making a mistake. That is his main symptom also. So you match it also at the level of the keynote. Keynote represents the main quality of the remedy. And then you go to the soul of remedies and you see, you can read silica. Silica is a psychotic remedy and silica has to do much about cover up. Its cover up is, nobody should see my inner weakness. Nobody should find fault with me. Nobody should find my mistake. This is his main anxiety. Did you get that picture from him? Nobody should see my fault. And it's like a glass, also mirror. So silica's like imitating or copying because it's very fixed in the image. They have to retain the fixed image they created for themselves. The main feature of silica is, what do others think about me? Is this what he said is his main quality? Yes or no? This is how you have to match. What he said should be exactly in the book. This sentence, the most important feature of this remedy, what do others think about me, you will not find in any other remedy in Materia Medica. Okay? It is not important that people should think of him as good or nice, but they should think of him in a particular manner. He wants the exactly, and if the fixed image is lost, like when appearing in stage or meeting new people or interview or exam, he develops a lot of anxiety and a severe fear of failure. Is this exactly what he said? So, more or less, many times I find that patients, they speak exactly the language that is written, as if it's made for them. Right? So, silica may appear like lycopodium because lycopodium is also lack of confidence. But the miasm of lycopodium is psoric. So, he's very hopeful. So, he's afraid, but he will do it. And when he does it, he will gain courage and he will do very good job. Silica will remain like this, restricted, psychotic miasm. Okay, so the main theme of lyco is, can I do it or can I not do it? But in silica, that my image has to be protected at all costs. So silica is even afraid to appear on stage. Means you tell him, go and receive one prize on the stage also, he will be scared because people are looking at him. Whereas lyco, the anxiety is, can I perform or will I do a good job or not a good job? Are you with me? So they constantly feel the eyes of others on themselves and they are very conscious about the impression they are creating. This is the main feeling of silica. And therefore, give ready-made answers and they even rehearse a lot of replies which are point to the point and formal. So before they come, they rehearse, and this is what he said, before I met you, I was going on in my mind what I'm going to say, what I'm going to say. So they feel that they have to fulfill this image as a necessary condition of acceptance. And like that, you can see this creates tension and timidity in the presence of others. So, Silica woman actually tries to fulfill an image made for her by somebody else. And therefore, she yields to that image and becomes fixed to it and in her effort to maintain it. This is what she has to just keep on doing that. Mm-hmm. So outside she will say yes, but inside she has a completely different opinion. And therefore you have the symptom in Silica, a delusion. Yeah, huh? Is it the rubric? Materia Medica, okay. So, in the Materia Medica, it's confusion of identity, sense of duality. This is the rubric. Am I this or am I that? Like alumina, a little bit. Because alumina is just silica's neighbor, next door neighbor. Means flat 2A is silica, 2B is alumina. OA society mein dono. So, she yields completely and gives up her own goals and image. What she wants, she will give up and just become what the other person wants. I often think of Silica as a like a princess or as a prince. Bichara, nobody asks them what you want. He's supposed to, all anywhere he goes, people looking, is he behaving like a prince or not? Yes or no? This is the thing I would really hate in my life. To be a prince, because then you have to do what people expect out of you. It's the worst situation. I will suffocate, I think. What do you think? But lot of girls want to be princess, no? And they're looking for the prince also, right? I think so, yes or no? Prince charming, prince on the horse, but that is my nightmare, to be a prince. Ek jo, a certain image, no, that you feel that this is my worst nightmare. So if somebody says, oh, you are a doctor, you are supposed to wear a tie and a coat and this and that. Tumhe yaar, humse nahi hoga, aapko aana hai to aao, nahi to jao. But I am not going to yield to your expectation of how I should be. Do you follow? You don't, or you do. You don't follow, or you follow. You will not follow, okay? Will you follow what I am saying? Oh, good. I remember, I'll tell you personal story. My father used to be a very well-known homeopath. So, he always used to wear full sleeves and tie to the clinic. Oh, in that time, doctor means like this. Even today, many consultants you'll see in big hospitals with a tie. Nah? That is their, like a uniform. He used to, for many years, 15, 20 years, I never seen him wear a half shirt. Never, even in everyday life. Usko tha hi nahi. So one day, I was a bacha na at that time, means must be 12, 13, 15 years old. I told him, father, why don't you wear a half shirt? I said, he said, what? Half shirt? I've never worn one. I said, chalo, you and me will go to tailor shop and we will stitch the same cloth, say, two half shirts. One for you, one for me. Thoda sentimental blackmail, basically. He agreed. Then he came, we both stitched the same cloth me se. Then he said, I'll try wearing this to the clinic one day. So he wore. Then he came in the evening and said, it's very comfortable, huh? From that day he never wore a full shirt and a tie. I'm responsible for. He always after that, he said, ye to achha hai, comfortable hai. Why I was doing for 20 years? And his practice didn't reduce. So, kya hota? If you are confident about yourself, no? And you feel, I'm fine. I don't have to be what you think, but I know who I am. You know, I don't depend on your evaluation. If you have that confidence, which Silica doesn't, so it's a stage of life when you, in childhood, you want to confirm, are wo pehen raha hai, mujhe bhi pehenna, you know, otherwise I'll be out, what they'll think of me. This is a stage, then you pass that stage, you say, no, I'm fine who I am. And then you develop a reputation. I'll tell you another funny joke. Means these are things that happened. One patient had come. This was many years ago. So, a new case. He left and went. Then I saw that he had left behind by mistake in his case paper a postcard. Written to him by somebody else. Naturally, curiosity. No? Oh, we postcard. Open. I read. Usme likha hai, referring him to me. Somebody telling him, oh, usne andar dal diya in his case record form. What he has written, that other fellow, that you go and meet Dr. Sankaran, first of all, you will not be impressed at all. Means you will find a very ordinary looking fellow wearing one half sleeve shirt. Doctor jaisa dikhta bhi nahi hai wo. Then he will ask you such silly questions you cannot believe also. Means stupid questions, what you like, what you don't like, whether you urinate sitting down or standing up. All these funny questions he will ask you. Just reply. Then he will give you medicine. He will not talk to you. There will be no lectures. Just he will give you medicine. Take the medicine. For 2 months nothing will happen. Don't worry. After that you will see what happens. This is called reputation ho jata hai. Now imagine if I had worn full sleeve and tie that fellow. He'll be shocked, no? So, if you have confidence, then you don't have to yield to anybody. You do what you believe. I believe that the tie is not for Indian people. Ek to is like a dog chain, no, basically. Horse also. You think horse? Hot, it's hot. Yeah, it's hot also. Yeah. Hot in a bad way. You can. Okay. Aajkal hot. Wo dusra ek hot bhi hota hai, ek cool bhi hota hai. It's cool. Ek hot, ek cool. Wo you have to learn the language nowadays. So it's ek to yahan lagta hai. And full shirt and jacket, not meant for Bombay weather. Do you agree?
Yes.
Yeah, but you see what doctors do. Yeah. तो उनको ऐसे लगता है दिस इज व्हाट्स गोइंग टू इम्प्रेस द पेशेंट. मैला मारो गोली. जो हूं आना आओ, नहीं आए मत आओ. आई नो माई वर्क. आपको क्या काम से मतलब है ना. या वी गिव रिजल्ट. यू वॉन्ट सूट बूट और यू वॉन्ट ट्रीटमेंट. वॉट यू वॉन्ट. I'll tell you another joke if you want. My life is like this only, very funny. who was this? Well, it was a very. I had a teacher, very very strong man, you know, powerful, he will. Like a lion he was, very, very powerful man. One day, but I had very good relation with him. He was close friend of my father and we are very, very close. He liked me a lot. So I had the privilege to make joke with him sometimes. So one day, what do patients come to me for? Do they come to me for my jacket? Do they come to me for my shoes? Do they come to me for my trousers? What do they come for? He asked me like this. So I said, you try coming without all of this and see how many. He started laughing. I couldn't resist asking him, try coming without all of this. Okay, so so her survival depends on constantly proving to others that she is very good in a specific way. Another situation is like the crown prince who has to uphold the family name. Everybody's attention on him, you know, this British prince and all. Kahan jao? Camera. Anything he does is bloody newspaper. He has to sit, talk in a particular way. He can't go to a discotheque. Gadbad ho jayega usko. So this is the thing. So. Okay. So something like that you can see, and usually they develop problem in single parts, like this fixed otoria, or keloid, or fistula. These are very typical. Like one thing is a problem. and all these symptoms appearing in public, failure, and all this kind of things are. Possible. So you have a remedy that has the miasm, the sensation, the kingdom, the keynotes, the main problem of the patient. So why it will not work? And interestingly, both husband and wife same miasm, na? And very close also stage fright. So kya perfect homeopathic horoscope match. 8 out of 10 points. 8 rubrics are matching, दो ही अलग है. उसमें diarrhea from anticipation, इसमें image consciousness. इतना ही फर्क है. बाकी I think very perfect किसी ने match किया हुआ है इनको. है? Marriage never works हो गया. Whether you ये क्या? Are you married? क्या बात है? नहीं फिर भी नहीं कहा. अरे फिर कर. आप या मैच करो नहीं मैच करो बात एक ही है ना. व्हाट इज द सीक्रेट ऑफ अ गुड मैरिज? यू नो इट? नहीं Never get married. तो फिर आप तो ह्यूमन रेस को ही खत्म कर देंगे दो जनरेशन में. Then only cockroaches will be there. No, never get married is not the solution. But I will give you a lecture separately on that. If you want, pura semi, I can give a whole seminar. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. तुम लोग क्या सीखने आए इधर? Anyway, in short, the secret of a good relationship, marriage is also type of relationship, or friendship, or can say a connection with another person. Whole secret is the connection with yourself. How do you connect to yourself? How okay you feel with yourself? So if you feel okay with yourself, you are content within yourself, you are stable within yourself, then you can have good connection. Otherwise, your connection is based on expectations. Your connection is based on needs, desires. Your connection is based on your sense of inadequacy. कि वो आके मेरे को खुश करेगा. That never will happen. It will happen temporarily. 2 days you will prepare good food, but after 1 month, वो रहेगा नहीं, because she is also having her own pattern, her own expectations, her own problems, etc. So nobody and nothing on this world is going to give you this kind of happiness what you expect. So if you are stable in yourself, you find the secret of your own happiness inside you, then you can relate to anybody, whether in marriage or a friendship or a student teacher or patient doctor. That is the secret. When we look from outside, it will be sometimes good, many times bad. Then problems. But ये समझने को 30-40 साल लग जाते हैं. उसके पहले लगता है हाँ उसने किया नहीं किया ऐसे किया वैसे किया कैसे बोल सकती है ये सब problems. No? Yes. Yeah, confusion of identity is alumina. Yeah, it is there, but his main theme is not confusion of identity. It is not main ye karun ya wo karun. It was not his problem. You have to listen very carefully. It was not the question of should I be doing this or should I be doing that. His thought was, I want to do this, but in order to please other people, I have to go with them. So there was no division in his mind. He knew clearly what he wants, what he doesn't want. But in order to please other people and to fit in, he just goes with them. Right? And alumina belong in syphilitic miasm with very violent impulses, like to kill, to cut, to suicide. Why? Because in alumina, the basis of human life, which is ego, is destroyed. You don't know who you are. He knows who he is. Only in his desire to please other people, he seems to have forgotten or suppressed. Now, moment he loses consciousness of his image, his self will come out. In alumina, that it is not formed. Clay hai, it is a clay. Means you don't know what it is shape it is going to take. It is shapeless. It's a difference. Padho usko pyar se, okay?